So embolisation for the joints can be used to treat quite a number of conditions. So we've been using embolisation for the treatment of hypervascular tumours, such as those from renal cell carcinoma, for some time, particularly within the preoperative setting. We've also been using embolisation for those patients with bleeding into joints, particularly of the knee joint, so hemarthrosis, and particularly after knee surgery. And there's a good body of evidence for that. More latterly, embolisation within the field of MSK has been looking at treatment of specific disease conditions, particularly that of osteoarthritis, which I spent a lot of time researching with regards to embolisation in the context of the treatment of patients with knee osteoarthritis. So there's a wide breadth of conditions that we can treat using embolotherapies within joints. Akunu's great work as really the father of embolisation for joint conditions. There's been a raft of emerging evidence within the field of embolisation for osteoarthritis, particularly within knee osteoarthritis. And at the current time, we've got several cohort studies, several prospective cohort studies, which are all showing the same signal that embolisation of knee OA is safe with potential efficacy. Clearly, whenever there is an intervention designed to treat pain, we need to consider the placebo effect. And there are emerging trials now which are looking at sham procedures against genicular artery embolisation, which is the treatment for knee OA, to try and address that. So I think that we're in a good place with regards to the evidence. And if we look at prostate artery embolisation, which I think the IR community did fabulously well, gaining a body of credible evidence, I think we're really sort of at the beginning of that journey with genicular artery embolisation and embolisation within muscular skeletal conditions. And I think as more and more evidence emerges, what we're finding, as I say, is that there is consistency with regards to it being safe, with the same signal that there is potential efficacy at early to mid-term follow-up. Again, as more data emerges, I think we're going to improve our selection of these patients. At the current time, with the current evidence base, the ideal patient seems to be those patients with mild to moderate knee osteoarthritis that have tried a raft of conservative treatments. So a lot of the patients that come and see me as part of the Genesis trial will have already had a steroid injection. They may have had some physiotherapy. They may have even had an arthroscopy. And with failure of those conservative treatments, they're really only left with joint replacement surgery. And the orthopedic surgeons don't want to operate on young patients who've got mild to moderate disease. So they're really in a sort of unique treatment paradigm, if you will, because there aren't many options for that patient group. So from my research and from the data that's out there, I think genicular artery embolisation, treatment for patients with knee OA using embolotherapy, are those patients that have got mild to moderate knee osteoarthritis that are resistant to conservative treatments but aren't yet severe enough to warrant joint replacement surgery. And I think that's really where there's a potential great advantage for this technique for that pretty large patient population. I think it's a really exciting time for MSK embolotherapy, not just within the OA, which is my area of interest, but the work from Akunu and other groups are really exploring other areas of MSK. So looking at treatment of patients with shoulder problems, so shoulder frozen shoulder, looking at arthritis within the lower limbs. And I've even seen some emerging data looking at the role of embolotherapy within chronic lumbar back pain. So there clearly is a raft of research that's ongoing within this field. And as I say, I think it's a really exciting time for interventional radiology to try and improve the quality of life of these patients with chronic pain conditions, of which there are many. I think the main message is really we need to concentrate on data. So designing prospective trials, getting lots of data, real world data as well, with registries, I think, are important within this area. And I hope that we can mirror the great work that we did within prostate artery embolization, where we can gain a body of evidence that supports the use of not just knee osteoarthritis, but some of the other emerging embolotherapies within the MSK space. So I think the future is bright for MSK embolotherapy.